John Tyler was born March 29, 1790 in Virginia. So you can go and tell your friends when they're asking you, or you can just say, I got amnesia. He was born to a wealthy Virginia family and raised on a slave plantation, don't you see? He was able to live a privileged lifestyle because he had slaves to do all of his work. America! John Tyler was just 21 years old when he was elected to join the Virginia House of Delegates. Meanwhile, back on the farm, the poor slaves picked cotton and mended coats. That makes sense. John Tyler was the 10th president of America, and at age 51, he served 4 years until 1845, and then, wasn't president anymore. He changed careers. John Tyler was playing a game of marbles when he was given the information that he had become the president. He was like, don't bother me now because I'm winning. Okay, I'm pretty sure that's not actually what he said. John Tyler's main achievements were including Florida as part of the Union. I bet that's more than ya or I will ever do, so go and prove me wrong. He also approved Texas for annexation. Because his presidency was given so quickly after the sudden death of William Harrison, he was given the nickname of the accidental president. It's like, y'all can stop talking or be gone. He was the uncle of President Truman. He hung out with Tom Cruise and did a movie with Paul Newman. Okay, only one of these facts makes sense and is true. I'll leave the mathematics and figure it out to you. John Tyler was the first president to get married while he was in office. Yeah, he got remarried less than a year after his first wife died and fathered 15 children between his two wives. John Tyler was a musician and enjoyed playing the violin, especially for his 15 children. Hey kids, daddy made another song. Everybody follow along, sing all night long. After his presidency was done, he retired back in Virginia. This is where this transpired until the outbreak of the Civil War, when he agreed to serve as the peace chairman. He died on January 8, 1862 in Richmond, Virginia. The death was due to respiratory failure and severe fever. If you had this, you wouldn't be alive either.